Over on that far ridge, there's something very white in coloration. That is a jawbone. Yes! Wow! That is an amazing find. A legit jawbone. Oh, this is exciting.
Guys, is that a saber from a cat? Kind of looks like it, right?
Many miles out into the vast wilderness of the Badlands, the crew and I are searching for fossils alongside paleontologist Pete Larson. So far at this top secret dig site, we have uncovered the remains of two ancient turtles. And now with some fossil hunting knowledge under our belts, we have been turned loose to search for artifacts on our own.
Rolling?
Rolling.
Action.
Rolling? I'm rolling too.
Man, it's hot.
It is super hot. We have made some incredible finds thus far. Turtles and a whole bunch of little bones and teeth. Now, Pete has showed us the process that we need to go through to search for these fossils. And at this point, he has turned us loose and sent us on the mission of finding a saber-tooth cat skull. It could happen, guys. They do find them out here. Now, what I'm going to do is give you a GoPro, Mark.
Okay.
There you go.
Got my
and
GoPro.
Gonna give one to you, Mario.
Oh, I see what's going on here.
And then I've got one right here filming me. Now, we're gonna break down the main cameras and use the GoPros to film ourselves walking around searching for fossils. Now, if you find something epic, call it out. May the man with the best fossil win. Good luck, guys. Let's see what we can find.
All right, Mario, ready?
All right.
Let's do this.
Which way do we go?
Any way you want.
All right, I go this way.
All right, guys, they have turned the bone hound loose into the Badlands. Now what is this here? And that is just a rock.
Ooh. Look at this. That's pretty cool. That's one I'm gonna keep for sure. It's a
piece of a turtle shell right there. Just a fragment that's come down the wash, so it's tricky. This is a lot of times a good place to find fragments of fossils, but if you want to find something whole, you really need to look on the edges for something that just was exposed by the recent rains that came through the area. And that's what I think I'm going to find if I keep going this way.
Check that out. A little femur bone, I'm suspecting. That's cool, actually. There's the top of it. Those are worth holding on to right there. All right, we're gonna cut down through this valley and see what we can find.
Tell you what, it's hot out here. And finding fossils is not easy, that's for sure. Your eyes have to be trained to catch any different texture in the soil or coloration.
Look at this. This is a huge tortoise. There's a big piece of carapace right there. Wow. You can see where all the bones have just crumbled down the hillside. Now that's considered an ex-turtle, as Pete calls them. Nothing to be collected there, but for me, still a cool find. All right, I'm almost to the top of this ridge, and that's where we're gonna find something cool.
Now look at this. This is a tiny, tiny rodent jaw. It's amazing because you would think, how are you going to find such a tiny object? But it actually stands out quite well in this type of substrate.
Over on that far ridge, about there, there's something very white in coloration sticking out of the substrate. Could just be another piece of a turtle shell. It's big enough to be a skull. All right, I'm going for it. I'm gonna have to slide down through this canyon to get there. And we're just gonna go for a basic skeet slide here. Here we go. Now I gotta get up the other side. A lot easier said than done. Oh my goodness.
Guys, is that a saber or a cat?
Check this out. That is a jawbone. Yes! Wow, that is an amazing find. A legit jawbone right there. Okay, let me look around, see if there's anything more of it. Yes!
Get out of here. That is awesome. Man, I wonder if there's any more of it.
Oh, this is exciting. Very gently. Yes, almost lost it here. Wow. Stay there, knife. That is the find of the day for me right there. The jawbone of, it could be a cat. Those look like cat teeth. All right, I gotta investigate this area a little bit more and see what else I can find. Yes, yes, that is a huge find for me. Man, the skull hound delivers.
Cool. So, found this fossil here. Looks pretty big, it's dense. This is the biggest fossil I've found so far. Everything so far I've been finding have been tiny, like mandibles. But this appears to be maybe some type of leg bone or arm bone, not sure. But anyways, I'm gonna put this in the pack and go see what else I can find.
I have investigated the area pretty well, and I don't see any more fragments of the skull. I'm checking down in this canyon now with the hopes that maybe something washed all the way through. But, more teeth. Right here, look at this. This is a different animal, but that's another jaw right there. All right, I think I'm, more jaw. Hold on a second, what's this? This might be the back of a skull. It is. It's the top of the skull. I found a skull. Hold on a second. Yes. Man, striking again, okay. I've got small jaw fragments right here and what appears to be a cranium, without question. Look at that. You can see where the brainstem connected. It's all broken apart, but that is a skull. All right, guys, well, I got a pocket full of good stuff. I think it's time to head back and meet up with the team.
All right, guys, well, we are back from the adventure. It was hot, it was dry, it was dusty, but we all made it, and it certainly was epic. Now, we found lots of incredible specimens. Look at all these fossils. On the end, we have Mario's. In the middle, we have Mark's. And right here, we have Coyote's. Now we have placed our prized fossils out here on these pieces of wood, but we've saved our best pieces for last. And at the end, we're each gonna reveal our most, you know, sort of celebrated relic.
Kind of like our grand finale.
Yeah, the grand finale. So yeah. What I wanna do now is first we're gonna go through Mario's stuff, then Mark's, then mine. And Pete, if you would be so kind as to help us identify some of these fossils,
sure.
That will help everybody out there watching know exactly what it is we found.
All right, so Mario, you're up.
Okay.
All right, buddy, what did you find? Man, looks good.
All right, so I do know what this one is.
Yep,
that's tortoise.
Turtle, yep.
Turtle, okay. And then I kind of get lost over here with maybe some type of mammal.
So this actually is also turtle.
Okay.
So that's a turtle tibia, the distal end of a turtle tibia.
Gotcha.
Another piece of turtle here. This is a pelvis, part of a pelvis. You can see right where the femur would go right in there. Anybody needs a hip replacement, contact Mario.
Okay.
And then we've got Leptomerix. Leptomerix is a relative of the antilocaprid, the modern day pronghorn.
Ooh.
This is actually a little paleolagus, a little rabbit jaw.
Cool.
And this is a mouse, a guy called Yumies, or as they said in the Oligocene, Yummies.
All right, Mike, you want me to take over on that camera?
Yeah, here, you want to take this one?
Sure, I'm going to cut the GoPro here.
All right.
And we'll take this. Still rolling?
Yeah, I'm rolling.
Okay, get the earbuds. Oh, yeah, all right, Coyote's got the big camera.
Man, you got a lot, Coyote.
I did.
You got a lot of fossils. I had to work hard for my stash, but I'm feeling like my grand finale is going to be worth the wait. But just before then, let's go through these. I know what this is. That's a turtle. I thought that was pretty cool. This is this looks like a piece of a carapace.
Yep, part of a turtle as well.
Yep. This I have no idea. Pete, you're going to have to help me out on that
one. That's a humerus. That's an oreodont humerus, probably from the bigger oreodont Maracredit on Culbert Soni.
Okay. This is a shard of a bone, but it was larger, so I picked it up.
So a little bit harder to identify. Possibly, it looks like probably a long bone, probably a part of a femur from something big like one of the rhinos.
Ooh, rhino bone.
Yeah.
Possibly. I'll take that. And then I have a whole smorgasbord of different looking teeth here, and I'm not sure if they're all the same species.
So you have uppers and lowers from this guy called Leptomerix evansi. And then this little guy here is a little tiny antelope called Hippicidus. So this is a pretty rare little guy here.
Oh, cool.
I think we found only one skull here the whole time we've dug here.
All right, Coyote.
All right, I filled almost an entire 2x4 with fossils. Now, like I said, I am the bone hound, the skull hound, and I actually found a crushed skull out there. Now, Pete, I don't know what species this is, but it is definitely a cranium. And you can see where the back of the skull would connect to the vertebrae there.
Yep, so that's a brain case, basically.
Yep.
So this is judging from this, and also the teeth all match Leptomerix, so Leptomerix evansi.
Okay.
The antelocaprid. And both maxilla, and there's looks like some of the mandible, too, there. So that's very cool, all the same beast.
That was one of my coolest finds. Then I found even bigger jaw pieces. Whoa. Now, I got really excited because I thought that I had found the cat skull. I just saw these two pieces sticking up from the dirt, and I saw these big sharp tips dug down, but these were the only pieces that I managed to unearth. Now, what are those, Pete?
So, and these are actually two different individuals. You can see they're both the left maxilla.
Oh, wow.
Of the oreodont, probably Maracredodon helprini.
Okay.
So sort of the middle-sized oreodont. But you can see they're exactly the same.
Really? Because I found those like both right next to each other.
Isn't that interesting? You'd think they'd be the same, but it can't because it's repeat.
Yeah.
They're both left maxilla.
Very cool. This guy had two left feet, as they say.
Yeah, that's right.
I have a couple of other teeth and jaw pieces here. But then check this out. This is some sort of a femur bone or tibia?
It's distal femur.
Okay.
It's just missing this condyle here. Probably goes back together. Maybe missing a piece in between. But
yep.
Yeah, so femur, probably oreodont again.
Of course, a neat little piece of turtle carapace.
Yep.
I found this then bigger bone. Again, maybe a...
So this is actually humerus from a turtle.
Oh, from a turtle?
Yeah,
turtle bone. Okay.
Yeah.
Neat, big turtle bone. All right, guys, well, it's about time to reveal our final prized fossils. Should we start with Mario?
Yeah, I'd say we go back down the line. Mario, why don't you hand your camera to Coyote?
There you go.
Coyote, why don't you get the tight shot?
Yep.
I heard you might need two hands for this fossil.
Well, I saw this, and it's definitely the largest fossil that I encountered. And
it just made a thump, everybody.
Yeah. And so it's definitely dense. And weight, and I'm thinking it's some type of leg bone.
Whoa!
So I found it. There's kind of top part of it. I'm gonna see if I could get it back in place there. There you go. So that's how I found it, just on the ground, and it's pretty big. So
that's a big
Tyrannosaur?
Guy. No, it is mammal, and it's one of the biggest mammals that we have out here. This is a rhino tibia, distal tibia.
A rhinoceros.
Yep, and you could tell by the shape of where the astragalus would go what it is.
Whoa.
And so this is one of the very biggest animals that was out here. This and the giant pig. So it's an animal called Subharachidon occidentalis.
Subharachidon. Yeah. Subharachidon, a big prehistoric rhino. All right.
All right, Mario, you may win big fossil of the day. Big bone of the day goes to Mario.
All right, who's next?
All right, I guess that would be
Mark's
me.
Up.
All right, guys. Now, this is one of those situations where I think I found something pretty cool, but I'm not 100% sure. So I'm gonna be a little reserved in my reveal. But if it is what I think it is, it might be the fossil of the day. All right, you ready?
Ooh.
So.
You got me curious
I
here.
Think
Whoa.
I may have found the saber to a cat.
You did, that is.
What? Yes, that's, yes.
Wow.
That's a saber from a dinectus, the base of the saber. So this is all root here. And there's some breaks. Unfortunately, it's not complete, which would be really awesome. And where's the skull that this should be in?
I know. It was the only piece I could find, but I do know where I found it. So I will let you guys know so we can mark it down.
Yeah, we'll go back and check it out. But, oh, that's awesome. So far, you're the only one with a cat today.
Yes.
So it's not a whole skull, but it's the best we got so far. That's awesome.
Yeah, I saw the bend in it, and I was like, that feels like it could be a saber. So
that was real
awesome ID.
Saber. It's a saber. That's what I got, guys. Coyote, it's your turn.
What do you got, Coyote?
So Coyote's supposed to have a complete saber tooth cat skull in his pocket.
What?
That's what I'm expecting here.
Well, guys, I did not come back with the saber tooth cat skull. I saw one out there, but it wasn't pristine condition, so I just kind of left it.
You just left it?
I just left it. I didn't think anybody wanted to see it.
What, have a broken saber or something?
No, it had a bunch of dust on it. It just looked really aged. No, no saber-tooth cats, but...
You got something for us.
I got something cool. Check out that jaw piece.
Nice.
Yeah, that's awesome.
That's a nice, nice jaw.
Now, this has a cool story to it as well, because I did spot it from a distance. I had to scale down into a valley and mountain goat climb up to get to this and filmed it all the while on the GoPro. And sure enough, as I got close, I got so excited. I said, it's a jawbone. Oh my gosh. And then as soon as I grabbed it, I was like, the skull's got to be here somewhere. Did not find the skull, but for me, that is a pretty good find. Now, Pete, what species is this?
So that's Maracoidodon culbertsoni. It's the oreodont. It's the biggest of the oreodonts that were down here in the lower Oligocene.
Very cool.
And there's something cool you may not have noticed. See that little hole there?
Yeah.
That's not supposed to be there.
Really?
So it was fed on, possibly by a hyenodon, because the hole's round, not like a cat would be sort of. So that's a poke hole from a tooth.
Okay, so something might have bit or chewed on this jaw.
Yeah.
Well, that could possibly explain why it's all broken apart, and this is the only piece I found. But pretty proud of this fossil.
Very nice jaw.
I'm going to place it down there. Wow.
Here, let's take a step back in the shadow. Let's have a look at the final.
That is cool. What a layout of incredible prehistoric prizes right there. Now we have Mario with the rhino bone. Of course, Mark with the cat saber. And then there's me with the oreodont jaw. Write in the comments section below and tell us which one of these finds was your favorite. Now, every one of these specimens is going to be taken back to the Black Hills Institute, where it will be used for research purposes. And while we didn't find the saber-toothed cat skull today, that just means we'll need to return to the Badlands to find some more fossils. Pete, thank you so much for having us out today. We could not have done it without you. I'm Coyote Peterson. Be brave. Stay wild. We'll see ya on the next prehistoric adventure. Of the countless expeditions the crew and I have embarked upon, searching for fossils in the Badlands alongside Pete Larson is by far one of our most memorable. No, we didn't find the coveted saber-toothed cat skull we were all hoping for, but that simply means we will need to one day return to this fossil-rich location. The art of paleontology requires an incredible amount of patience, and while the conditions are often harsh, with a strong will of persistence, you are almost certain to find prehistoric treasure. Stay tuned as we return to the Black Hills Institute, where Pete teaches us how to take a fossil from the field and perfect it into presentation status. If you enjoyed all of these incredible fossils, make sure to travel back in time and watch where the adventure began as we headed out into the Badlands. And don't forget, subscribe so you can join me and the crew on this season of Beyond Dinosaurs. This is the foot of a bird.
So that's an avian dinosaur, technically.
This is a modern day dinosaur bone, for sure.